Hello and welcome to this video where I show you how to upgrade the memory in a Dell G5 15 Special Edition 5505 laptop. I'm going to be replacing the two factory fitted 4GB modules with this Kingston HYPERX memory, which is a 32GB kit of 3200MHz CL20 DDR4. I'll leave the model number for this kit in the video description, but other models may work. If you do choose a different make and model, you obviously want to make sure that you choose 3200MHz modules, but you also need to make sure that the modules operate at 1.2 volts, otherwise the laptop may not be able to run them at their rated speed. So to begin, you want to make sure that you have disconnected the laptop from power and also disconnect any devices that you have connected. Close the lid and flip the laptop onto its back. Grab a Phillips head screwdriver and remove the 6 small screws on the bottom of the laptop furthest from the display hinge, making sure to put them somewhere safe so that you don't lose them. They're all the same size, so don't worry about getting them mixed up. The 4 screws nearest to the display hinge are captive screws, so just loosen them as far as they'll go. With all of the screws now removed, or loosened, grab a pry tool or guitar plectrums as I'm using here. With these, you want to wedge the bottom of the laptop away from the dark coloured panel that houses the keyboard. There are a number of clips around the edge of the laptop. You should just be able to run the tool around the edge and feel for them to unclip them one by one. Let me give you a better view of where I'm using the tool. Not forgetting to remove the SD card you've attached. With the front and the sides of the laptop's base now unclipped, it's time to unclip the most difficult clips at the back by the hinge. The process for this is the same, but it's a little more tricky, but can be done with some patience. Once all of the clips have been released, the base can easily be pulled away and put safely aside. With the base now off, it's time to open the replacement memory so that we have somewhere safe to put the modules that we are removing. To remove the fitted modules, pull back the flap and start with the top module first. Pull both retention arms outwards away from the modules until the installed memory pops up. When the module pops up, pull it out of the slot and place it safely aside. Repeat this process for the bottom module. With both modules now removed, grab one of the new modules to be fitted, and starting with the bottom slot, push the module into the slot diagonally, making sure that it is as far in as it will go. Once it's as far in as it will go, push it down until the retention arms click into place around it. Repeat for the top module. I found the top module to be more difficult to push into the slot than the bottom one, so be careful to make sure that it's definitely all the way in before pushing it down. Now, with both of the new modules installed, grab the base of the laptop and push it back into place around the edges until all of the clips are back in. With the clips back on, start by fastening the captive screws, followed by replacing and tightening the screws which were earlier removed. Having done that, replace any devices you need connected and turn the laptop back the right way up, open the lid, and turn it on. If all has gone well, the laptop should display a message that the memory has been changed, to which you could just click a button at the bottom right to continue into the operating system. Once in the operating system, check that the correct amount and speed of memory is showing. If it is, then you have successfully changed your laptop's memory. Thank you for watching. I plan to cover the performance changes from 8GB to 32GB in this laptop in a future video, so please be sure to hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss any further videos.